So today I'm going to present how to get into model-based system engineering, model-based safety assessment process with a dedicated toolchain. So during this presentation, I will briefly introduce the company, AlphaTech. Then I will show an overview of Safety Architect. And finally, I will present two interfaces that we have with Safety Architect. The first one is an interface directly with Capella, and the second one is an interface with System Modeling Workbench through Teamcenter. This is the first time I'm going to present this second interface publicly, so I'm very happy to share it with you today. So let's talk about AlphaTech. So we have been a software publisher for nearly 25 years. We are experts in model-driven engineering, which means that our various tools are based on this technology. With our tools, we address different technical domains, risk analysis for cybersecurity and safety, and test and validation. The application areas of our customers are mainly from the defense sector with the French Armament Agency and the associated electronic companies such as Thales, MBDA, and others. We also work with company involved in critical fields such as the aeronautics, space, and energy, etc. Another part of our activity is dedicated to research and development. So we are often involved in French or European projects related to the different technical domain we address, so cybersecurity, safety, and test and validation. Now, about our different tools. So historically, our first tool is Matelot. It is a model-based testing tool. So concretely, in Matelot, the user designs state transition diagrams to represent the behavior of the system. And from these diagrams, we are able to automatically generate test cases and test suites. And if the user also adds script on the transition, it is possible to automatically generate test scripts to automate the execution of tests on a test bench, for example. Then, for risk analysis, we have two tools for cybersecurity risk analysis. These tools are based on the French EBIOS methodology, which is defined by the French Agency for the Security of Information System. So Cyber Architect supports the previous version of this methodology called EBIOS 2010, and Agile Risk Manager supports the new version of EBIOS the new version of the method EBIOS, which is called EBIOS Risk Manager. And finally, we have Safety Architect for the safety risk analysis. So I will present this tool during this talk. So let's start with Safety Architect. So first, some background. So the development of Safety Architect started 10 years ago. But in the beginning, the tool was very different because the safety analysis was based on equation. So it was not very user-friendly. So in 2013, we integrated Sirius to replace the equation with diagrams. So by the way, I invite you to review our presentation from the last year at SiriusCon to learn more about our experience with this module. Then we worked with Thales already in 2015 during a research and development project dealing with system safety co-engineering. And from this work, we implemented an add-on for Capella and a bridge with Safety Architect. Finally, we are currently working with Siemens to interface Safety Architect with Siemens tools, so Teamcenter and System Modeling Workbench. So I'm going to present these both interfaces during this webinar. So why did we create Safety Architect? What are our main goals? First of all, we want to provide a tool dedicated to safety engineers. So This means that our users must be able to create classical, classic analysis, classic safety analysis. For instance, the preliminary risk analysis, more especially the one for specific domain, such as the functional hazard analysis for the aeronautic, or the HARA for the automotive domain. Then, with Safety Architect, we can also generate fault trees and FMEA or FMECA tables. The second objective, and I already talked about this a little bit, is the fact that we want to provide a user-friendly way to manipulate safety concepts. So based on diagram rather than on equation or Excel table, which are unfortunately still too much used. The third goal, so we want to ensure consistency or at least promote co-engineering between the system and safety teams. So that's why the starting point for the safety analysis in Safety Architect is a system architecture. This system architecture can be a high-level architecture, so a functional architecture, but it can also be a more detailed architecture, such as a software or a hardware architecture. And the loop indicates that this process is iterative because when the results of the safety analysis don't meet the safety objective, safety mechanism must be added in the system architecture to improve the safety of the system. The fourth and last objective is to interface with other engineering tools to become part of the engineering ecosystem. So first, for the analysis produced, such as the fault trees, they can be exported in different formats. The reports can also be exported in the most classical document formats. We can import system architecture from various system engineering tools. And we have transversal connection for the requirements and with the Siemens Product Life Management tool, Teamcenter. And finally, we can import security data from our tool, from our other tool, Cyber Architect. And the goal is to combine safety security co-engineering in order to potentially find conflict between the need of the safety team and the security team. Okay, so let's start the demonstration of Safety Architect. So this is Safety Architect. So Safety Architect is an Eclipse-based tool, so like Capella. So the interface is really similar with Capella. You have the Project Explorer, you have the palette, you have the Properties tab here. For instance, we also have an Activity Explorer. Yes, so it's very similar because it is based on the same technology. And first, I'm going to present you an analysis on a functional architecture. So it is a UAV model, so unmanned aircraft vehicle architecture, a functional architecture of this system. So normally, at this stage, we want to conduct functional hazard analysis. So for this, we have to add a .fhi file in Safety Architect in the project. And you simply have to open it to conduct and to fill this table. And what is interesting is that to fill this table, the information are supported by the items that are in your model. So for instance, in the first column of the FHA table, we have to add to select a function. So we only have access to the function that exists in the model. So you can select a function. Okay. Next, we have to select a failure condition of this function. So you only have access to the function, to the failure condition that belongs to the function that we selected previously. Okay. Next, some other column can be filled with thanks to list. And this list are customizable, can be customized in the preferences of the tool. We also have textual stem. Here you can select a hazard that we added in the project, and you can assess this row, this risk. And when you select a value, the DAL is automatically computed, and also the quantitative safety recovery. And we have many other columns that you can fill manually or with lists. And this list, again, you can customize it in the preferences of the tool. Okay. We have something similar for the automotive. So I can close this project. Oops, sorry. For instance, here I have another project, an active cruise control, a functional architecture of an active cruise control for the automotive domain. And in this case, we don't want to conduct a F5J, but a HARA. So it's the same principle. You have to have a .HARA file in your project. And you have a similar table, but specific for the automotive domain. So with specific column, with specific list, etc. But again, you have to select function in your model, the malfunctioning behavior, etc., etc. You can assess the severity of this event, the exposure, controllability, all the fields that are needed to perform HARA for the automotive domain. So this was first part was dedicated to the presentation of the analysis at a functional level. And now I'm going to present you another project. It is a hardware architecture of a Whipper system. So here we have a hardware architecture. It is a simple project. And what we have to do. So for the moment, all the projects that I present, the architecture have been created in Safety Architect, but it is not the goal of Safety Architect. We don't promise that we are a system engineering tool. The best is to import the architecture from other tools, but in Safety Architect, we have the basic concept to construct, to design system architecture. But in the next demonstration, I will show you how to import models from Capella or from SMW. So I come back to this project. So in this project, it is not very complex. I have only one level in my architecture. In this level, I have the subcomponents. And now I have to perform the safety analysis. For this, there is a .feared_events file where we can list the hazards or feared events that we want to study. So you can add several feared events. You can write the name that you want for this feared event. And also, if you want, you can assess the severity of this feared event. So the severity depends on the situation when this feared event will happen. So this severity is just a preliminary assessment. We'll be able to change it later. Okay, so this is the first step. And next, we have to fill the local safety analysis of each component. So for this, we double click on a component. And now we have access to a new representation. And we call this representation the local safety analysis. And the goal in this representation, the goal is to represent the failure condition of the components. So for this, we have different kinds of concepts, of safety concepts. So first, we have the events, the system events. The system events are used to represent system events or environmental events that can impact the components. So for instance here, electromagnetic interferences. The local events are used to represent things that can go wrong in the component. So for instance here, I put a generic local event, that I call internal failure. And I could add several local events in the component. Next, on the input port and output port, we have the failure mode. So by default, we propose the most known failure mode, so absent, untimely or inadvertent, and erroneous. But if needed, you can also add your own failure mode on the port. And on the failure mode, we can also, for some failure mode, we can also allocate feared event or hazard on a failure mode. That's why here we see the feared event logo, because the feared event that we created in the .feared_event file is allocated on this failure mode. And next, we have to describe the failure condition or the propagation of the failure between the failure mode and the events. That's the goal of this kind of representation. So for this, we have the different gates. And next, we also have another concept, the barrier. The barrier is used to represent existing safety mechanism in the component. And we have to do this local safety analysis for each component. So we have to come back to the architecture and go to the next component. We have something similar and we continue like this, DSU, etc., etc. Next. That we created the propagation, we can add specific information on the failure mode. So in the properties, when we select failure mode, we have a FMECA properties section where we can add specific information on the failure mode that will be used when we will generate the FMEA table. And there is also an assessment properties part section where we can assess the failure mode according to your domain. So for the automotive, you have access to the exposure controllability, and for the FMEA, you have the occurrence and detection. And same thing, for instance, on this failure mode, we have similar information. Okay, now that we filled the local safety analysis and the information on the failure mode, we can now propagate the failure. Propagate, next. I select for which feared event I want to propagate the failure and finish. And from the information of the system architecture and the information of the local safety analysis, it automatically generates a fault tree for this feared event. So it is what is proposed by default for the user. But with this generation, we also automatically generate other information like a risk report. A risk report, it's like a matrix, a risk matrix, but we choose to represent it in another way. Because in a risk matrix, when there is a lot of risk, it becomes unreadable. That's why we choose this representation, but it is the same principle. You have all the risk, and with the different color, you can see which risks are the most critical. And on the risk, you can click on the risk, and again, you have specific properties for that you can set for the risk. Now we can also generate the FMEA. So, next, I select all the failure modes of the project and it automatically creates the FMEA table with the main part of the FMEA is automatically filled. So we have the function, the failure mode, the failure local effect, the failure end effect, etc. The assessment criteria, the severity, occurrence detection, and the risk priority number is automatically computed based on the, it is the multiplication between these three criteria. And if needed, you can export this table to Excel if you want to perform modification in the table. But also some column can be are editable directly in self-checkout. And another type of report, the textual report. It is a textual report that contains all the information of the project. So it contains information about the system architecture, about the local analysis. All the information are textually represented in this report. Okay, so I can close this project. So it was a basic architecture with basic concept for the system architecture. But as we want to interface with other tools like Capella, we added in Safety Architect more advanced concept to be able to import Capella model in Safety Architect. That's what I'm going to present you. It's the same project, but it is another representation of this project where we have the three architecture level. So the functional level, the logical level, and the physical level. So it is, so we added the same concept that we have in Capella to be able to import the Capella model in Safety Architect. The only difference between Safety Architect and Capella is the allocation. In Capella, when you put a function in a logical component, it automatically creates an allocation because the function is contained in the logical component. But in Safety Architect, we choose to represent the allocation with links because thanks to these links, it adds new ports on the component. So here you have the output port, the classical output port, and now we have new port. It is the allocation port, and thanks to this port, we are able to propagate failure between the different architecture levels of the system. Like this, for instance, you can propagate, you can have a physical failure in a physical component, and you can propagate it through the physical architecture and to the logical level and finally to the functional level. So like this, you can propagate through all the level of the architecture. That's why we choose this representation. Okay. So this is, the end of the demonstration of Safety Architect. I can go back to my presentation. And now that you know more about Safety Architect, I will introduce you to our Capella add-on and bridge with Safety Architect. So what does our add-on contain? So first, it integrates a safety viewpoint into Capella that will allow basic things to be done for the safety analysis. Secondly, it contains a smart bridge that will help the user to select information and share it from Capella to Safety Architect. So different scopes of analysis can be chosen depending on the user needs and the type of data to be exported. So for instance, it is possible to select function. And if we select this scope, all the related functional elements will be automatically selected by the scope. And we have the same behavior for the components. If you select components, all the related components item will automatically be selected by the scope. The goal is to be sure that when you switch from Capella to Safety Architect, we want to ensure or to support the user to be sure that the user will not forget information when he switch from Capella to Safety Architect. We also offer two cross-selection modes, which means, for example, that if you select function all associated components where the function are allocated will be automatically selected. And conversely, you can select components, and in this case, automatically, all related functions will be added to the scope of the analysis. So I will show you all this during the demo, and I hope it will be more clear in the demo. And last thing, so both tools are connected. So like this, it improves the mean to share data between Capella and Safety Architect. And I will also show you that we are able to navigate from Capella to Safety Architect. So from Capella to Safety Architect, we can share data from the system analysis level and from the logical and physical architecture levels. And from each of these levels, data should be selected in architecture blank and data flow blank diagrams. For information, we maintain our add-on so that it remains compatible with our Safety Architect evolutions and obviously also with the Capella evolution. Now, I will talk about the workflow we imagine when we starting implementing our add-on and bridge with Capella. So at first, we need a system architecture. So this is the job of the system team. When you have first functional architecture, for instance, the system team and the safety team can have a meeting where the system team presents the system model to the safety team. And maybe they can also already talk about the safety, discuss about the hazard and things like this. Once the safety team is familiar with the system model, they can select the information in Capella that they want to export to Safety Architect. For this task, the user is assisted by the smart bridge that I presented earlier, and the bridge will help the user to make sure that they don't forget any information when they switch from Capella to Safety Architect. Next step, we export the data to Safety Architect. And next, we perform the safety analysis as I already show you during the Safety Architect demonstration. So we perform the local safety analysis. To perform the local safety analysis, if you don't want to navigate in the system architecture in Safety Architect, you can navigate in the system architecture in Capella to open the corresponding view in Safety Architect. Again, I will show you this during the demo. Next, we can perform this safety analysis, so generate FTA, FMEA, FMEA table, etc. If needed, safety mechanism must be added. And when the safety team reach the safety goal, we can export information to Capella. And the only thing that we can export from Safety Architect to Capella is the safety critical functional chain. The safety critical functional chain is like a representation of the failure propagation in the system architecture. Again, I will show you this during the demo. And this safety critical functional chain can be used for the safety team to present to the system team what are the issues in the system architecture, where the safety analysis has been performed, etc. So it is the next step. System team and safety team must have a meeting again, where the safety team presents the result of the safety analysis and presents the needed safety mechanism. And maybe all the safety mechanism can be implemented. So maybe we need to find trade-off with the system team to reach the safety goal. And when both teams are agree with the safety mechanism to implement, the system team can modify the system architecture. And now that the system architecture has changed, we can perform again all this process because all this process is iterative. And the goal is to reach the safety goal and also to reach the system constraints, etc. So I can start the demonstration of the bridge between Capella and Safety Architect. So as you already know, this is Capella. So first we have to install the safety add-on in Capella. So after the installation of the safety add-on in Capella, you will see a Safety Architect logo in the Capella toolbar. This Safety Architect logo indicates if both tools are launched and if both tools are connected. In this case, Safety Architect logo is in color. It indicates that both tools are correctly connected. In Safety Architect, we have a connection logo which presents the same information. Okay, so I imported the Capella example, the in-flight entertainment system. And now I'm going to show you how we can share data between Capella and Safety Architect. So first, I'm going to show you this on a functional architecture. So I'm going to open a high level functional architecture. So this is a functional architecture of the in-flight entertainment system. And now we want to use the safety viewpoint in the project. So for this, first, we have to enable the safety viewpoint for the project. So for this, right click. Okay, back. Okay, so simply right click on the safety viewpoint and click on reference. And now the safety viewpoint is active for the project. But now, if you want to use this safety viewpoint in the diagram, you have to enable the safety layer. Now, when the safety layer is active, it added a new item in the palette, and we can also see red square around the port. It indicates on which port we can add feared event. So here, for instance, I'm going to add a feared event here. I can change the name of this feared event. I can choose on which kind of failure mode this feared event will be allocated. So for instance, absent. Okay. And now it's the only thing that we can do for the safety viewpoint in Capella. Now we have to export the information to Safety Architect to conduct the safety analysis. So for this, for instance, I can select all. I have to go to the scope feature and create a new scope. So as I am at a functional architecture level, I'm going to select function because I want to export all the selected function to Safety Architect. Okay. And thanks to the scope, the scope indicated that 90 elements were selected manually. But the scope detected that 7 implicit items must also be added to the scope to be sure that you will not forget information when we will switch from Capella to Safety Architect. And in the middle, we have all the tree view of the Capella project. So again, if you want to select manually other information that you want to export to Ceftia Architect, you can select it manually here. And now we can export to Ceftia Architect. So as I already told you, both tools are connected. So I can simply click on Export to Ceftia Architect and it automatically creates a new project in Ceftia Architect. And now we can conduct the safety analysis in Ceftia Architect. So at this stage, we are at a functional level. So maybe we want to conduct a functional hazard analysis. So we are going to add this file in the project and perform and fill this table. And to fill the analysis, if you want to add information in the local safety analysis of the function, so as you can see, we can't keep the layout between Capella to Ceftia Architect. That's why we allow to navigate from Capella to Ceftia Architect. So for instance, if we want to add information in this function, we can right-click Ceftia Architect, open a relevant diagram, and it automatically opens the corresponding view for this function in Ceftia Architect. And for instance, here, we can see that in Capella, we only have the function manage video and audio diffusion. But thanks to the scope detected that this function has sub-function, and the scope detected identified that the sub-function could be useful for the safety analysis. That's why here we have the sub-function in the function manage video and audio diffusion. Now I can open the local safety analysis of this function. And it's inside, I can see the failure mode, etc. And here I can see a failure mode where we see the feared event that, or the hazard that we added in Capella. And now we have to perform the analysis as I already show you during the Safety Architect demonstration. Okay, so I can. Okay. Now I'm going to present you an export between Capella to Ceftia Architect through at a physical level. I skip the logical level because at the physical level there is many information, so I think it is a more interesting level. So I open a PAB. In this PAB, I have a function, logical component, and physical component. Again, if I want to use the safety viewpoint in this diagram, I have to enable the safety layer. Now, if I want, but it's not mandatory, but if I want, I can add a feared event on the port. Again, if I want, I can change the name. I can choose on which type of, on which kind of failure mode it will be allocated. And again, now we have to select the information that we want to export from Capella to Ceftia Architect. So to show you another type of example of another type of scope, I'm going to select only the functional chain that is represented by this blue square. So I only select one item and I create a new scope. And this time I'm going to choose the scope functions to components. It means that the scope, this scope will select all the related functions based on my selection and all the related components where the functions are allocated. So logical components and physical components. I have the same principle for the components. If I selected components, I could use the nature components to function. And in this case, all the functions that are allocated on the components that I selected will be automatically added by the scope. So I choose this one. Okay. The scope is computed and we have the result of this of the scope. It indicates that I selected only one item, the functional chain, and the scope identifies that 153 items are needed to be sure that you will not forget information to conduct your safety analysis on the item we selected. So in this case, the functional chain. And again, if you want, in the middle, you have all the tree view of the Capella model. So if you want, you can again manually select other information, other items. And now, again, we can export to Safety Architect. And again, it creates a new project in Safety Architect. And this project contains all the information that has been selected by the scope. So again, as we can see, we can't conserve the layout between Capella and Safety Architect. And in this architecture, there is many different links, many different information. So we try to work on the arrange all feature, but when the architecture is very complex, it's very difficult to automatically organize the layout. But it's possible. I can show you that it's possible, but obviously it requires a bit of effort. So to show you, I already exported the same diagram and I organize the layout just to show you that it's possible to get something more readable in Safety Architect. But again, it requires a bit of effort. But as I already show you for the functional architecture, if you don't want to work on the layout in Safety Architect, you can completely navigate from Capella to Safety Architect. Simply right-click on an item, Safety Architect, open a relevant diagram, and in Safety Architect, it opens the corresponding view to conduct the local safety analysis of this item, in this case, of this function. Here we can see the field event logo, hazard logo. And again, we can see here the field event that we added in Capella. And now we can perform the local safety analysis. So I'm not going to perform all the local safety analysis, but just for the demo, I'm going to add a bit of information. Okay. Next. It's POP3, right click, Safety Architect, open a relevant diagram. POP3, Aeonius, for instance. And again, we have to do it for all the functions and components of the architecture. But just for the demo, I only filled two local safety analysis. Another difference between Capella and Safety Architect is that in Capella, we mainly use the exchange between the function and the link between the components, and we mainly rename this exchange and links. But in Safety Architect, it's a bit different. We mainly work with the ports. But unfortunately, in Capella, by default, all the ports have the name FOP1, FIP2, etc., etc. So in Safety Architect, it's a bit difficult to identify the port because we are more used to work with the name of the links in Capella. So for this, I implemented a Python script. So I use the add-on Python for Capella, and I implemented a script that can automatically rename all the ports of the model. So it will add the name of the action of the link to the port. For instance, this port will become FOP3 packetized audio stream, etc., etc., for all the ports like this. It's easier to navigate in Safety Architect. Okay, so I did the safety local analysis. And now, as I told you, it is not mandatory to add a field event in Capella. But what is interesting when you add a feared event or a hazard in Capella is that you can generate the fault tree from Capella. So right click, Safety Architect, and run Global Safety Analysis. And in Safety Architect, it automatically generates the fault tree. And again, another interest when we generate the fault tree from Capella is that it adds, it automatically creates a critical functional chain. So the critical functional chain has been created in the Capella model, but we don't see it in this diagram. To see it, we have to click in the palette. We see that in the model, a critical functional chain exists, and we select it because we want to see it in the diagram. Okay. And we can see the function, the safety critical functional chain in the diagram. Here, in this case, obviously, the functional chain and the safety critical functional chain overlaps because the starting point of my analysis is based on the functional chain. That's why they overlaps. But in other diagrams, I could have a critical functional chain that is independent from the functional chain. Okay, so I almost finished the presentation of this demo. Yes, one last information about the bridge between Capella and Safety Architect. So if you perform modification in Capella, in the system architecture, you will need to export again the information to Safety Architect. But in Safety Architect, it creates a new project. So in the new project, you will not have the safety information, the local safety analysis that you did in the previous architecture. But no problem, in Safety Architect, we have a specific feature, which is called interactive merge in the tool. Internally, we also call it a diff merge function that allow you to compare two versions of a project. And like this, you are able to import information from the previous project to the new one. And like this, you don't need to conduct again all the safety analysis of all the components and functions. Okay, I think that's it for the presentation of the Capella add-on and bridge with Safety Architect. And now, last part of this webinar. I will introduce you to the interface between System Modeling Workbench and Safety Architect. So, just first a slide to present it. To start, to be honest, I'm not an expert of Teamcenter. So, what I'm going to present you is my point of view of what I know about Teamcenter and the interaction with SMW, etc. But if you want more information, don't hesitate to contact the Siemens expert and they will give you the needed information. So how it works? SMW, it is Capella that already integrates a specific add-on, and more especially, it integrates a Teamcenter add-on and other add-on. Teamcenter is a product life management tool. So for me, it can be seen like a hub where all the information are gathered. Not all the information, but all the main information that are interesting to be shared between the different teams of a project. So, in SMW, a Teamcenter plugin is already installed, and with Siemens, we worked on the implementation of a Teamcenter plugin on a Teamcenter add-on for Safety Architect. And Siemens teams also work on the creation of dashboard to nicely present the safety information in Teamcenter. So Teamcenter has two goals. The one is to gather information between different tools. And also it also propose dashboard to show in a nice representation with metrics, etc., the information from the different tools and teams. And like this, you are able to follow the progress of your project and of the different teams. Let's start with the demonstration. Okay, so first we start SMW. So SMW integrates Teamcenter add-on. So we log in Teamcenter directly in SMW. We already have a project in SMW. It's a Whipper system. It's a similar example that I presented to you earlier. In this project, we have only one architecture, a physical architecture. And in this project, we can see specific green logo in the system analysis level, logical architecture and physical architecture level. It indicates that the information in this level are synchronized with Teamcenter. So we have to click on a share model to share the information with Teamcenter and to send the information to the hub. And now that we exported the information, we can see Teamcenter ID that has been added to the SMW project. So now we can start Safety Architect. So in Safety Architect, we have the Teamcenter add-on that allow to connect to Teamcenter. So in Safety Architect, we can log in to Teamcenter and we can open the active workspace. So the active workspace for Teamcenter is the place where we will find all the information that are shared between the different teams. So we can see in this active workspace that there is a project from SMW, and we can see the main information about this architecture in Teamcenter. For instance, we can see the diagrams and we can see the different components, physical components, logical components, etc. And also the function, the physical function. And now we are going to import this project in the project explorer of Safety Architect. So we initialize the project. So get all the projects that are available in Teamcenter and we select one of them and it's automatically imported in Safety Architect. So now we can see the physical architecture that we imported. This is the physical architecture that we imported. It is exactly the same one that the one we have in SMW. And now, as I already presented to you, we are going to perform the safety analysis of this architecture. First, we can add a shared event. If we want, we can assess the severity of this shared event, but again, it's a preliminary assessment. We will be able to change it later because the assessment of the severity depends on the situation again. Okay. Next, we have to perform the local safety analysis of each function and component. So again, I'm not going to present the local safety analysis of each component, but I will only present the local safety analysis of two functions. So here, I'm going to add a feared event to allocate a feared event to a feared event mode. And now, we conduct the safety analysis. We represent the failure propagation. Next, for another function, etc., etc. Okay, and now we can also change the properties on the failure mode. And now, okay, on this failure mode again, other information. Okay, and now, as we are used to do now, we are going to propagate. So we generate the fault tree and it also generates the risk report. And on the risk, as I already showed you, we have also specific properties that we can change here. Okay, and now that we did the safety analysis in Safety Architect, so here I changed one of the properties, and now that we did the safety analysis in Safety Architect, we can, okay, just before, we can also generate the textual report. It's the last step of the safety analysis. We could also generate a FMEA table, etc. Okay, so now that we finished the safety analysis in Safety Architect, we can now publish this safety analysis to Teamcenter. So right click Teamcenter and publish. And automatically, all the information are sent to Teamcenter. So now we can open the active workspace of Teamcenter to see what how the safety information are represented in Teamcenter, in the active workspace. So in the active workspace for the safety analysis, we can see the architecture diagram. We can see the local analysis. And we can see the report that we generated. And we have also different tabs on the workspace. We have specific metrics and charts for the risk. In the table below, we have all the list of all the risks and all the specific properties for the risks. Okay. And something similar for the failures, with specific metrics, specific charts, and all the lists in the table. We can see that on one of the failure modes in the project, hazard is allocated with a severity of 7. And the hazard tab, where we see that in the project, in the safety project, there is only one hazard, and we have the main information about this hazard. And last tab, about the relation, it presents all the relation of this project with the different diagrams, reports, etc. And now, if we want, we can change value in Teamcenter. So for instance, here we change the severity of the hazard. And in the risk, we are going to change the risk acceptance level of one of the risks. So now, we can go back to to the, we can close the active workspace to go back to Safety Architect. And now we can update to import the information that has been changed directly in Teamcenter. And now we can see if we open the .shared events file, we can see that now the severity is 6. And for the risk, we can see that the risk acceptance level has changed as we did in the Teamcenter Active Workspace. And obviously, it only changed for this risk. For the other one, this properties has not changed. Okay, so thank you. It is the end of my presentation. Just a few words. Yes, so I show you Teamcenter in Safety Architect, but you can also have the same interface. You can have Teamcenter in SMW. So like this in SMW, if you want to see the local safety analysis of a specific function or component, you have access to this information from the Teamcenter add-on. Okay, so this is the end my presentation. So it is a lot of information. So I try to show you the most important thing. So don't hesitate to visit our website or to contact us if you want a specific demonstration or if you want to see more detail about these different tools and interfaces. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Jean. Thank you for your presentation and for sharing some of your insight with us. It's time now for questions, even if actually we are already out of time.
Yes.
But still, we'll take a moment to have a look at them. Okay, for first question for you. For the quantitative risk assessment, how do you derive your probabilities of failures?
Yes, I skipped this part because I wanted to show the main part. But on the local event and system event, we can associate a failure rate on this concept. And like this, in the fault tree, you will have all the probabilities on the node of the tree.
Thanks. Second question. Can I choose another form of the .fha for a different product?
So we propose some columns by default, so you can show or hide some of the columns, but you can't add your own columns. If you want to do it, you need to export most of the work in Safety Architect. And after, you have to export it to Excel, for instance, and add your own column if you want. But after, if you buy Safety Architect and you need a specific column, it's possible we can add it for you for your need. We can do a specific implementation depending on our customer needs.
Thanks. Can you modify the control signals only for unwanted control actions?
I'm not sure I understand this one. The control signals?
Yeah. Can you modify the control signals only for unwanted control actions?
Yes, maybe it's not clear for me, but yes, we can. I don't know if it answers the question, but we can only add the failure mode on the ports that are linked to the flow, to the data flow in the system architecture. So it can be done on the exchange between the function, but it can also be done on the links between the logical component and the physical component. And after, okay. If you need to add specific failure, you can use the system events to add specific things.
OK, Can this tool be integrated with a RAM database or import NPRD data?
So not for the moment. It's not playing for the moment. But it's something we can check. We can see with you with our customer. Yes.
So thanks for having attended this webinar. It was a pleasure for me to share this moment with you. I hope it will be the same for you. Have a good day and goodbye.